Day two.
Two.
Power Camp Virtual.
It's awesome.
Back at you. Bearded Brothers are back.
Here we are, man. Here we are.
Woo. Woo. You look good, man.
You look great. Good morning.
You're no hair thing. It just works.
Well, thank you. I don't know what to say. Thank you.
Well, welcome to day two. Okay, today we got some great things lined up for you. But first and foremost, let's check out this verse, Mark 12:30. All right? You must love the Lord your God.
Yes.
With all your heart.
Come on.
Soul.
Yes.
Mind.
Strength.
See, you didn't think I'd memorize that. You thought I'd forget
Mark
it, huh?
Mark 12:30.
Thought about it all night.
Did you hydrate? Did you hydrate last night?
Yes, I did.
Good.
Lips
good.
Are a little parched right now. But
are
yeah.
they? Mm-hmm. Okay, well, that's good. You guys
coffee.
Make sure you hydrate this
hydrate.
Morning.
Hydrate. We got a big day. Stretch. We got baseball day. We got baseball day.
Yes.
Today.
Yeah. Dingers.
We
all
got
day.
Awesome worship for you. Yeah. Hey-o.
Hey-o.
This is what I want for worship today.
Tell
okay?
him. Tell him, Saul.
Instead of sitting and watching worship today, we want you to participate.
No.
Okay? We want you to get off the couch, parents, kiddos. All right?
Let's
get a little action, a little high knee action, you know, a little hand raise.
Hand raise.
What kind of hand raiser are you?
I'm a dual hand raiser, but I've got a microphone in my hand. So, yeah, I go here a lot.
I'm a big receiver.
Oh, that's good. I go there sometimes. I like that.
Palms up.
Palms up. Receive. You always got to be receiving from the Lord, for sure, 100%.
Or I'm a big one of these. Raise the roof.
No, I don't know about
that. Is
that
not cool anymore?
Maybe for you.
Okay, all right. But hey, participate in worship today, all right? And then remember, we want to experience this camp about 40, 35 minutes, okay, however long the instruction goes. Then get out there and do the challenge, man.
Do it.
Do the challenge.
Do it. Today's going to be a great day. I just feel it.
I feel it too. In my heart.
Day two is always a good
absolutely.
Day. For
absolutely.
Sure.
So welcome back to day two. We hope you enjoy.
Let's go.
From the sky, leaving heaven's throne, I was meant to die, but you wouldn't let me go. The riches of your grace, I could not afford. My gift has been replaced, now I'm forever yours. What a price you paid, trading the highest place. Lay down your crown for me, how great a king. From death I've had you
To FCA Power Camp. We are so glad that you've considered joining us here today as we continue to talk about what does it look like to be 100% and all in. I'm Nathan DeVoe here with you this week, as well as my friend Clinton Faupel, and we are just so excited to share today's message around 100% of God and sacrifice, and what does that look like? And when we think about what does it look like to sacrifice, to go all in, it's so important that we look at Scripture, because we have no better example than what is set for us right in the pages of the Bible. In John 3:16, this is a verse that we all know, we recite from the time that we're little and grow up through church. It's, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have eternal life." So God gave us 100% by sacrificing his Son. And let's make this personal. For those of you that are sitting on the other side of this screen, for God so loved Nathan, for God so loved Clinton, for God so loved Ryan, for God so loved Samantha, that he gave his one and only Son. And his Son was Jesus Christ. And Jesus also gave us his all. When he took our place on that cross, he went all in. That wasn't a metaphorical or a propositional, "Oh, I'm dying for you," but that really happened. And he didn't go halfway. He didn't give 50%. He didn't get to come down off of that cross, but he gave us 100%. He gave his one and only life so that we could find life. And that's for each and every person who's watching us today. So we have the example of our God and of our Jesus, of someone who can give 100%. And that really sets the table for us as we think about what does this look like in my life.
You know, sacrifice for me is not easy. I'm just going to be very honest. I'm a pretty lazy guy at times. I kind of like to get by, just kind of squeak by at times. And that's really burned me a number of times over my lifetime. And as I think about sacrifice, I got to ask the question, you know, what am I willing to do? What am I going to do to get the job done? And when I was younger, again, I just did whatever I could to get by. But sacrifice, when we think about that word, it must mean something really important. As we look at John 3:16, again, God gives his one and only Son. And he does it in such a way that he gives all of himself to that. And so could it be that God's wanting you and I to sacrifice all of who we are? Now, that's a big thing to think about. Does that mean I'm supposed to jump fully into a missionary job, or am I supposed to jump fully into being a church leader? I think it's a little bit easier than that. I think it's more of a, I'm all in, God, with all the things I love so much about my one and only life. I'm all in. And so today, as we think about what you might need to sacrifice, it might be that which you love the most. It might be that which, when you daydream, you think, "Man, I think about that all the time." That might be what you have to sacrifice to God. I'd also challenge you to think about this. We've got one life to live. We don't get do-overs. You know, we start when we're born, and one day, 100% of 100% of us die. And so what does it look like to live our life to the full, to live it 100%? You know, I would ask you, what would be the most amazing life lived for you? Some of you might say, you know, money. Some of you might say to be like the Fortnite champ. Some of you might say to be the person that's the best athlete of all time. But let me ask you, if you look at the end of your life and you think backwards, I know that's kind of strange, but in your final days on this earth, before you go to meet Jesus, how have you lived your life? Have you lived it to the full? And I would suggest the only way we live our life to the full is to ask the one who gave us that life in the first place. How do I live this life to the full? We're going to talk about that in the next few days, but it starts with sacrifice. God, what in my life right now is so important to me that I've got to lay it before you? And maybe it's pride. Maybe it's anger. Maybe it's fear. Maybe it's worry. Maybe it's something that you're not even quite sure of, and you're going to have to ask God to continue to show you. But we want to help you do that this week through these times together, because really God's asking us to sacrifice 100% of ourselves so that God can give us back the most amazing gift.
Yeah. I also am not the biggest fan of sacrifice, but I've learned through the grace of God and through just how he's led me in my life that it is often through things that I lose or that I give up where I have the greatest learning, the opportunities for growth that I wouldn't have sought out for myself. And personally, I wish this was just a one-time, hey, here's the sacrifice, and now I'm good, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But what Jesus tells us in Scripture is that we are to pick up our cross daily and to follow him. Yeah. And so take the question that Clinton is asking and go, okay, if I'm going to live fully for you, here's the question that I want you to ask. Write it down in your journal. Think about it right now, is to say, what is the one thing or the thing that is most taking the place of Jesus? Or what is keeping me from living fully for him? And then each day, whether it's just a part of this power camp or it's something that you apply to your life going forward, I would just suggest that you pray a simple prayer. Because a lot of times the things that we're called to do or that Jesus outlines for us in Scripture, in our flesh, it's really hard to do those things. And it's not my desire to sacrifice. So I've got to ask him for new desires. I've got to ask for his grace and his strength. So I would just say, Jesus, with this day that you've given me, would you help me to recognize that you have gone 100% all in for me, that you gave your all? And in turn, would you help me give my 100% in light of what you have done for me? And from there, as he begins to shape our heart and to teach us and to grow us, then we can also begin to give our all as well.
Okay, hi, I'm Coach Buckingham, and this is my son, Duke Buckingham. Today we're going to talk about the proper way to throw baseball, okay? A couple things that we do is we need a reference point, okay? And the chest is always a reference point. So you're going to notice when Duke throws and when I throw, we always bring the ball to the chest, okay? After that, we go into our throwing motion. And the next thing is going to be a strong position. So I want you to make a muscle on the camera. You're looking at the screen. I want you to make a muscle. Duke, I want you to make a muscle. Ooh, make a good muscle there. Ooh, we're making a muscle here. Strong position. The thing I love about the strong position in baseball, it reminds me of the Bible. Ephesians 6:10 tells us to be strong in the Lord. And that's a good reminder. How do we throw a baseball properly? We got to stick our elbow out, okay? Stick our elbow out, we make a muscle, and it's easy to remember because that is the strong position. So if we want to be a thrower with accuracy and with velocity, we've got to be strong. Okay, in a lot of areas of life, we got to be strong to be successful. So this is good. One thing that I saw as I've studied the game, this is something that everybody can identify with. This is a bow and arrow. Okay, this is obviously a fake bow. There's no arrow, but it's a fake bow. But one of the best ways to demonstrate this is what kind of position do we make with a bow and arrow? Okay, I'm going to turn sideways here in the camera. Right now, we've got our arm out. We're pointing towards our target, which that's what we do in baseball when we throw. We point towards our target so we can be accurate. But I want you to notice my position with my elbow here. My elbow is out. This is a strong position. So we might reference this as the bow and arrow position here for throwing a baseball, which is really, really important. So I like props. You're going to be thinking about what it means to be a warrior, what it means to be strong in the Lord. A warrior's got to have a weapon, okay? And you can think about a bow and an arrow. Okay, now we're going to do some demonstrations. Fielding the baseball, Duke's going to be fielding the baseball, and what you're going to notice, a couple things that we talked about earlier, the reference point. He's going to be bringing the ball to the chest after he fields it, because he's got to be able to throw the ball from the same place every single time, regardless of whether he throws a ball over the top or even sidearm, he's got to have a reference point, okay? Also, what you're going to notice, a big thing is he's going to be in motion towards his target. After he fields the ball to throw it, he's going to be in motion towards his target. And you're also going to notice he might even take a couple steps after he throws it, okay? Because he he has to be in motion towards his target. So here we go. We'll take a look at this here. Good job. Hustle back. Let's get one more in. Good job. Good job. Now this time he's going to throw the ball sidearm. Okay. Infielders, as an infielder in baseball, you got to be able to throw the ball from all angles. So in order to throw the ball sidearm, we still bring the ball to the chest, but the body tilts. So everything's the same reference point. If we were to shoot a bow and arrow, tilt it over, it'd be the same motion. Okay. So you're going to notice here, as he throws the ball sidearm, everything's basically the same, except there's going to be a little body tilt. Good job. Okay. Lastly, on a fly ball, let's say there's a ball in the air on a fly ball. You're still going to notice that after he catches the baseball, it doesn't matter if it's a ground ball, if it's a fly ball, he's still going to bring the ball to his chest, okay? And he's still going to be in motion towards his target. So it all looks the same. It all looks the same. Let's take one more, Duke. Good job. Nice work. Okay, so what can we remember about how to throw a baseball? First of all, the reference point is the chest. We always have to bring the ball to the chest. We have to have a reference point so we can be accurate. What's the second thing? We got to be strong, okay? Elbow out, make a muscle, strong position. What's the last thing? We got to point at our target. Remember the bow and arrow? It's an easy thing to remember. You got to be a warrior. You got to be strong. Okay. You got to be strong. And lastly, what you noticed about Duke when he fielded the ball, after he would field it and throw it, always in motion towards his target. We never want to throw the ball standing still. So hopefully you took a little bit of something that you can learn, that you can use with being a better baseball player. Thanks a lot.
Hello, I am Penny Beto-Wolf, and I'm with Fort Wayne ATA. We have two studios. We have the Coventry in the southwest side of town and the Stellhorn location on the northeast side of town. We are excited to be here and be a part of the Fellowship of Christian Athletes Camp Power Camp. The level of skill and accomplishment you will see today doesn't happen. You have to work for it. It takes dedication, perseverance, discipline, and hard work. What does perseverance mean? Never give up. Face the cameras. Cheer up. Kunye. And you're dismissed. Miss Sophia Smith will demonstrate the long-range bow staff. It is a big stick. She's dropped it on her head a few times, but she always bends back down and picks it back up, and she never gave up. Don't fall asleep, because she will wake you up. Ma'am? Chirp. Kunye. And Sija. Chuck, Kunye. And all that practice paid off, and she didn't drop it today. So that's always a good day. Today, Miss Isabella Smith, a third-degree black belt and bronze medalist in combat, will demonstrate a portion of third-degree form, along with Miss Adelaide Seth Smith, a world champion in combat, will demonstrate a portion of second-degree form. Face front, chair up, Kunye. Junbi. And CJ. Yeah. Abraham's next. Yay. Thank you, ladies. Along with forms, you can also train in weapons. Mr. Abraham Smith will demonstrate the nunchuck form or single songjibang. Face front, chair up. Kunye. Chunbei. Your form, sija. Chup, kunye. Awesome. Once you put in the time with your basic training, then comes fun stuff. The discipline to practice and the perseverance to not give up pays off with amazing ability to perform. Next up, Mr. Graham Smith will perform an extreme weapons form, and hopefully you can hear the tribute to Michael Jackson. Face front, chup, kunye. Miss Naomi Smith will bring you the world's greatest showman doing the jongbong or bow staff. Many drops in life. The only time you lose is when you don't pick yourself up and go again. Many times have they dropped their equipment and they still keep going. Self-control is also an important aspect in everyone's life. We have to have the courage to do what we are supposed to do, not what other people think we should do or pressure us to do. Sparring demonstrates a high level of self-control. If I can throw a kick and control it, I can throw a kick to hurt you. Mr. AJ Smith and Mr. Davis Hoffmeyer, Miss Isabella Smith, Miss Lizzie Dunlap will spar. Face front, chair up, kunye. Face your partners, chair up, kunye. And see jump. Good. Awesome. And come on. And face your partner. Chop. In life, sometimes your attacker is bigger than you are. So at this time, they're going to switch partners, please. This is Bella. There you go. Thank you. And face your new partner. Chop. And see jump. And come on. Face your partner. Chop. Kunye. And face the cameras. Chop. Kunye. And you're dismissed. At this time, I'd like to introduce Mr. Davis Hoffmeyer and world champ, Miss Adelaide Smith, to demonstrate combat weapon sparring. It's done with a padded stick. Face your partner, chair up, Kunye. Yes. Mr. Smith, you're nice. And siege up. You're next.
Same. Yeah.
And make sure they're in order for board breaks, too. And come on, and face your partner, chop, kunye. We always make sure we show respect and courtesy to each other after class. In life, we need to set goals, make a plan, and stick to it. Use your discipline and your practice, more practice, and even more practice. Bronze medals, Mr. AJ Smith will demonstrate a little Darth Vader. Imagine if his bow staff was a lightsaber. Yeah, okay.
If you only knew the power of the dark side.
All right, we like to demonstrate our power as well, but we have to have confidence when we do it. At this point, we're going to demonstrate board breaks. First up will be Mr. Davis Hoffmeyer. Mr. Abraham Smith will demonstrate a palm heel strike. Woo! Next up, Miss Isabella Smith will do a step spin heel kick. Miss Adelaide Smith will do an axe kick. Miss Naomi Smith, a spin hook kick. Miss Lizzie Dunlap, a jump round kick. Mr. Graham Smith, a back fist. Miss Sophia Smith is going to do a twist kick. And Mr. AJ Smith is a jump front kick. All right. Now we have a special guest to break a board today. He's got confidence and he's been practicing off on the side. So if Mr. Matt Ant is out here on the floor, he's going to demonstrate a palm heel strike. He's, woo! And if everybody could line back up, please. You can do anything you set your mind to. push yourselves, practice, and have the confidence to do the right thing. Thank you for letting us be a part of your camp this year. Chirp! Kunye! Thank you, everybody.
Dude, what are you doing? What are you, dude?
Dude, I'm giving baseball signals. Hold on.
That's a good one.
Was that it?
I think I'm supposed to sacrifice bunt. That's what I heard. Sacrifice
bunt. Sacrifice
bunt. We're back.
Woo, we're back.
Beard Brothers, the Boston Brothers are back because it's baseball today.
About this.
You look good. I mean, that looks nice. That looks good on you.
Learned a little something about baseball.
Yeah, man.
Oh, how about that verse today, huh?
John 3:16.
For God so loved the world.
All of it.
For God so loved the world.
100%.
That he gave his son.
Mm.
That's beautiful.
It is, man.
It's beautiful, man.
That stirs my heart every time I hear it. It really does.
It really does. Jesus is awesome.
He is awesome. He is so awesome.
Picture this. Jesus, God wrapped in flesh.
That's what I've heard.
Gave his life as a living sacrifice.
Ugh.
Oh, man. And upon confession, dude, we know Jesus.
Amen. Amen. You should preach that.
It's the Bible, man.
People should share that.
people
should share
really
that.
Cool.
That's really good
really
stuff.
Cool.
That's really good.
We hope you enjoyed today. We hope you enjoyed John 3:16 and sacrifice. We hope you enjoyed the baseball instruction. Now head out there, okay? Do the challenge. Communicate back. Let us know how you're feeling. Let us know how it's going.
They should hit some dingers today.
Dude, homers.
Hit some dingers, man.
Absolutely, woo! Man.
Bombs.
Yes, dude. I'm not.
Out of the park. Hit it out of the park. Hit it out of the park, Saul.
I'm a big bunt guy.
Bunt.
And still, you know, get
small
the first,
ball.
You know,
small,
small ball.
Ball.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's all, okay. Hey, however you can score runs.
Hey, I got a question. Put in the chat, who's your favorite baseball team?
Right here. This is it.
this is the only jacket I have.
This is it.
So, go Cubbies.
This is it. Yeah.
We love you.
Love you.
Day 2. We out.
We out.